Do you have an unlabeled old photo that you'd like to get identified? Or would you like to find some old photos of ancestors that you've never seen before? Well, you are in the right place because today we are talking about a website that can help you do both of those things. It's called DeadFred. Here to tell us more about DeadFred.com is the creator, Joe Bott. Hi, Joe.
Hello there, Lisa. Thank you very much for inviting me to come on. And hi, everybody. I'm glad to meet you. I hope you spent...
We're so thrilled you're here.
Thank you. I'm thrilled, too. I don't get a chance. I'm sitting down here in my little niche, scanning photos and putting them on my website so people can find them. And that's what I do for retirement now. I post photos, put them on the internet, and wait for someone to come knock on my door and say, hey, I know who that is. That's my great whatever. And it's happened already about 3,000 times since I've started. Actually, 3,167 times, just to be specific.
Oh, my gosh.
And
that is amazing. You look like you're down in the photo bunker.
I am.
Where you do all your scanning.
I've got my bunker. If you can see to the right of me, I have a small mountain of boxes that are full of photos and photo albums that are yet to be scanned in. Down my hallway is a skid full of boxes that have photos. They were bequeathed to me or given to me as a gift from a company that went out of business. Photo company, Genealogy Archive. So there's about 4,000 photos there. Then I received a woman that I know, and you know her. I'm pretty sure you do. Marge Rice from Joliet, Illinois. She was a genealogist. I met her briefly in Austin at a National Genealogy Conference, and we got off just perfectly. And she goes, you know, I'm going to leave you when I die, I'm going to leave you my photos. So years later, I get a phone call from her daughter saying my mother died and she wants you to have these photos. So I had to rent a van and drive to Joliet. I live in Arkansas. So I had to rent a van and drive to Joliet. And I had loaded this whole van up with photos. And that was about 3 years ago. And I'm just now finishing. And there were about 5,000 photos. So anyway, my wife loves it. She has me down in the cellar all day long. She doesn't have to worry where I'm at. I'm down here doing my thing. So she's happy.
I love it. Okay. Well, let's make sure we get everybody up to speed on what deadfred.com is, why you have all these photographs and people seek you out because they know that you're the photo guy and that you'll take good care of their precious images. Okay, so pretend you got in an elevator with a genealogist and you have that ride up to the top floor after a long day at a genealogy conference. How do you explain to them what deadfred.com is?
Sure, absolutely. So they ask. The name in itself causes people to ask me, what is that? What is DeadFred and why is DeadFred? And that gives me the opportunity to tell them. DeadFred is a photo. It's a photo of Frederick the Great, who died in Germany, a young man, but he had cancer of the throat. But my great-great-grandfather was living during that time in Germany. So there's a tie in genealogy-wise, but also there's a connection to it. My family, we were sitting around a table trying to figure out what to call the website. And that photo of Fred, and he's on my website, you can see him. Just scroll down on the right-hand side and you'll see him. But we were thinking about what kind of name to call it. That photo came in the mail. I had purchased it. Now I don't buy postmortem photographs. That's not my thing. Some people do. I don't. Anyway, I saw it on eBay. I had to buy it. It was cheap. I had to buy it. So it was a good deal. And it came in the mail. And we opened it up. And while we were talking, my son said, one of my sons, I have four boys. One of them said, why don't we just call it Dead Fred? Everybody seemed to like it.
And so it was born.
Here it was.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's the story.
So you're trying to reunite photos with families, aren't you?
Yes, I am. That's the whole purpose of it.
I want to make sure that people know what the website does, because we want to make sure that they know when they should be going there.
Okay. Well, let's talk about what it does. And I'll give you a short, okay, I'll tell you how it started afterwards. What it does is you take your photographs. If they're 1970 or behind 1970s, actually 65, and your people in the photographs are passed on, you can put them on there. It's free to use. There's instructions on how to post your photos. There's a big on there, there's a big thing that says post your photos. I click on that and just go ahead and do it. When you post your first photo, you'll receive a password in your email, and you can use that and manage your postings. You can post as many photos as you like. It might take a day or two to get up on the website, because I check every photo that comes in to make sure there's nothing untoward, because they do pop up every once in a while.
And Joe, people are putting their photos up there because they're not labeled, right? They don't know necessarily, or they may have acquired it and they're hoping that somebody will be related to that family who will want it.
Exactly. Okay. Yeah. And you know, a lot of photos don't have any idea, they're all names in the back. They have no places in the back, but many have a photographer's mark. And that is a, gives you an idea where they were at when the picture was taken. So there's a hint. Now, I would say half the photos on my website, 150,000 so far, have some kind of identification. But there's a section there that doesn't have anything at all, totally lost. And the chances of them being found are very iffy. But they are found. Because when people took their photos, they took more than one. They had copies made, and people had copies of a photograph. And I've had people come up to me and say, I know who that is. I have that photo. He or she is with a group of people, but that's who that is. So that works.
Well, aren't there people who are really into photographs who maybe they'll pick them up at an antique store? So it may not even come out of their own collection. They've acquired them somehow, right?
And sometimes, don't tell anybody, but they go into to diners, restaurants, like there's one restaurant that has photos all over the wall. I can't think of the name of it, but I go there for breakfast. It's a national restaurant, and they have pictures on the wall. I take pictures, and I put them up on the website, and so do other people. So they go in and have breakfast or lunch or dinner. And take pictures.
Now, they're like not Cracker Barrel, right?
That's exactly right. That's what it is, Cracker Barrel.
Yes.
So you go up, and nobody's sitting at the table. You go over to the table, take a picture, and you go. You put it up. I do that all the time. So
you that's might how reunite you do it with a family member down
yeah,
the road.
Right. Yeah. Exactly. So that's how you do it. It's simple. It's take your photo. Scan it, take a picture of it, however you make a copy, post it to the website, and hope, fingers crossed, somebody finds it. And they do. Now, listen, if I have photos, my personal collection is around 5,000 photographs. And the personal collection of the website is around 100,000, maybe 80,000. Because people are always donating photos to website to the Dead Fred. So the majority of the photos that I have here are donated. If somebody finds them If they belong, if they're physically on my premises, we'll send it to them for free. There's no charge. There's no charge to use the website. And there's a donation button that's always welcome to be used, but we don't push it. Mm-hmm. You know, we don't push it. And we just want to get the photos sent home. Now, I have some helpers. They've been with me since started. Most of two of them. We have Jeanette and Amanda. Amanda built the original database. Jeanette is a scribe. She's a writer. And they're great. Then Daniel is what we call the code poet. He takes care of our database. If something goes bong, he unbongs it. He collects it, fixes it up. And all I do is scan photos.
It's a long time, and I know it's been a real labor of love for you.
22
Have
years.
Have you always been this fascinated with photographs?
No, as a matter of fact, I didn't even know I was fascinated with photographs until 65. Well, I was in the Navy in Newport, Rhode Island, and I was walking down the street, you know, on Thames Street, and it started to pour. I mean, really poor. And I don't get my suit wet, but my sailor outfit wet. So I ran into this antique store. And I had to look like I was going to buy something. I didn't feel like I was a loiterer. But I found something. I found this photo album. And it looked, I said, it just totally amazed me. And it's almost like it was saying, buy me. And I had to. I didn't have a lot of money back then. I don't have a lot of money now, but I didn't have a lot of money back then either. And I bought it for $18. Now, $18 of 65 was a lot of money.
It was a lot.
Especially for a sailor. And
that
has just joined the Navy. So I bought it. And that was my first album. And I had it sitting up here on my cabinet. But that's how it started. I just said, wow, look at this. I couldn't get my eyes off it.
Over the years, when you and I have talked, and I have had you on my podcast, you've had some amazing stories of people who have searched the website. Maybe they're looking by location because they know, well, okay, I know my ancestors are from this little town in Indiana or wherever. And they go through the pictures and they spot a face they know. Joe, tell us one of your wonderful, inspiring stories of that reuniting of photographs and descendants.
When I was working, I was driving up to Iowa, and I stopped in a store, an antique store. And, you know, and I found some photos in a box, a whole family. And I bought it. I worked at a deal. I learned how to do it over the years, but I got a good deal on it. So I did my work, then went home and I scanned the photos in. They were from Saskatchewan, Canada. It was, anyway, I got a phone call, or actually got an email. I eventually got a phone call of a woman from Saskatchewan who says, that's my whole family. My grandparents. Wow. Their aunts and uncles, the cousins, the whole shebang. And apparently, now this is in the 80s, late 80s, early 90s for me. And those pictures were taken in 100 years before me. But they left Saskatchewan and they moved to Iowa. And they farmed there until they all died out. And there wasn't anybody to take the photographs. So down to Iowa, under some boxes, I bought them, put them up on the website. Somebody from Saskatchewan said they knew who it was, and they sure did. And then I sent them home. That was an exciting moment for that right there. Now, there's a lot of stories like that. There's stories where people cry when they find their photographs. Or somebody's dying, and there's a picture of a wife or a mother, and they want to show them the picture before they die. So there's a lot of stories to be told. I could write a book of the people that have found their photographs. And I send out a couple every week now. Matter of fact, I just sent one out, a baby, the baby now has died, got all died at the age of 88 to a grandson. Wow. Yeah. My mind's getting older, so I can't remember as much as I'd like to as far as names and places. But these kind of things, they stick in your head. You don't lose.
Absolutely. And what a difference you've made to families.
Well, yeah. Yeah, I understand that, and I enjoy that, and I just love it. I can't express it, but I love it. It's, you know, I don't drink. I don't smoke. This is my smoking and drinking right here. Now, I do other things. I like to go fishing. I hike. You know, I was over in Spain a couple of years ago. I backpacked over the Pyrenees Mountains. But I do things that are challenging. And this is a challenge, believe it or not. As simple as scanning photos, it's a challenge.
I'm curious, you know, before I let you go, I want to make sure that we help people find some photos that could be from their family tree. If they were going to deadfred.com and they head to the search box, what do you suggest that they focus on first when they're searching, and any other tips on how to use the website?
Yeah. Well, of course, surname is primary. And underneath that is location. You have the opportunity to fill in a location, the surname, the first name, the place, state, town, county. I have it down at the bottom. There's a little box. You put the keywords in there. You can, you know, write about what the family's about. Those are searchable. So put as much information as you can, because somebody will be doing a search with the keyword search, and they'll find it that way. So that's where you tell your story. You know, the fields are good. That's data, that's fact, like a date, age, place. The photographer's name. We have a photographer's name and place. There's almost 10,000 photographers. You can search them. If the photo has a photographer's name on it, you know, at the bottom on the cabinet cards, a lot of those have the names of where it was taken and the name of the photographer. So that'll help.
That's a great idea. That would be kind of interesting because I have some like from Germany with particular photographers.
Yeah.
Be interesting. Look at all the pictures they took. I might spot another one of the family, right?
You might. Yes, it helps. It does help because the photographer is at that place at that time. And if you have a date, you're getting close. You got to triangulate as much as possible.
Can we follow along on your exploits? Are you on social media, like on Instagram? Can we come and see what you're working on?
I'm on Instagram. I'm on Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, Pinterest. So, yeah, I'm on social media. Matter of fact, you go to Google and you type in deadfred.com and it'll take you all the places I belong. Or type in DeadFred Joe Bot and I'm there.
The website is deadfred.com and everybody can get in there and get involved. Search, post, do it for free, and even donate to kind of help you along with the cause.
Yes.
Joe Bot, this has been terrific. Thinking about interviewing you today got me thinking, I need to jump back on there and search. It's been a couple of months, but you never know, right?
From day to day,
there could be a new photo.
You never know. I said I have right here a big box. Now, you see that box? That's one box. That's one box out of 30 that came with the skid full of boxes. So I just finished this one today. I didn't start this till last week. So I got plenty to do. And feel free to write
you
me. You feel free to email me, ask me questions. You know, I'm here. I do it. I enjoy it. And I'll help as much as I can. People have trouble sometimes finding places. So I help them along that way. So there is, you know what? This community, this genealogy, you and Cindy, from Cindy's list of people who don't know her, Maureen Taylor from the photo detective. There's so many ways for helping that it's a tight community. I'm not a genealogist. I'm a scanner indexer. I don't know. I don't know what you would call me, but I appreciate
that's
genealogy.
That's an important role, my friend.
Yeah.
That's an important role.
But I appreciate what genealogists do because they're very intelligent and they're very specific and they're probably OCD, just like me, a lot of them, because they're very specific. And I like that. That's good. So I enjoy
everybody has a specialty
mingling with the, yeah. with the genealogists. I've learned some stuff too, but I don't have the patience for that. I have the patience for scanning and getting photos. So, hey, listen, I'm 76 years old now. You know, so I got a lot of work to do. I got to get it done.
Yes, you do. You have a lot.
And we got a lot of backup too. Awesome. So we got help. So that's good. Okay.
Well, keep up the good work.
Thank you, ma'am. What a difference you're making.
And you're absolutely right. It takes a whole community, doesn't it? We're all doing our own little piece, and you're playing a huge part in the photograph world.
Well, thank you. I plan to keep on doing a piece, too. Okay. It's good to see you, lady. It really is. You know, I see you here and there.
Good to see you.
You're always out talking and making speeches. So you're well known.
Yeah,
You're right up there with the top. So I'm glad that you gave me a tap on the shoulder. I appreciate that.